Hello guys, my name is Pizad Rashid. In this video, I'm going to be talking about conditional operator, or you can say ternary operator in C#. And hopefully my next video will be on the C# enumeration, also called enum. Keep watching. Please subscribe to this channel and make sure to hit the bell icon to receive notifications of my latest videos. So what is a conditional operator? C# provides a conditional operator. It's sometimes called ternary, question or decision-making operator. Up to you, whatever you call it. The symbol of conditional operator is this. Question mark and a colon. Basically, this operator uses Boolean value of true or false. And depending on the Boolean value, it determines which of the two expressions must be calculated and returned as a result. Don't worry, I explain that in a minute. Everything will be clear. This operator is actually a synthetic sugar for writing simple if-else statement. And the purpose of this operator is to make your code shorter and easier to read. Now let's look at the syntax. This is the syntax. Please pay attention. Here condition is tested to get a Boolean value of true or false, meaning this part of the expression will return true or false, nothing else. And the result of operator is either expression 1 or expression 2, based on the condition. In other words, if the condition is true, expression 1 is tested and becomes the result. Otherwise, expression 2 is returned as a result. Hope this is clear now. Please remember this. A conditional expression never checks expression 1 and expression 2 simultaneously. Conditional operator is a shorthand method of writing if-else statement like this. I'm going to use the C# online editor for the demo. You can find the link in the description below. Okay, let me write some code, then I explain it to you. Here I have set up two variables with integer values of 6 and 4. This is your conditional expression with conditional operator. This part is your condition, which will return true or false. This is the greater than operator. You can use different operators here, like equal to, not equal to, etc. Now the result of this expression is one of the two strings, string 1 or string 2. Whatever result comes from this side would be assigned to this variable. Now the choice of which string to assign, this or this, depends on the value of this condition. If the value is true, then the first string would be returned as a result. In case of false, the second string would be returned as a result. At the end, I have used built-in method WriteLine to print the value of result variable. Click run. Six is greater than four, which is true, right? So the result is this string. Conditional operator performs essentially the same task as the if-else statement. Let me write one. this line of code will work as a separator. If A is greater than B, then run this statement. Else, run this. Click Run. These two statements are identical. As you can see, both output same result. What if I change the condition from greater than operator to less than operator? Now the condition is false, and the result is this string. Looking at this statement, how do I know this condition actually returned false? Here is how. Just write your condition in the console.writeLine method. And it will print the value of condition in the console window. The value would be true or false, a Boolean value, nothing else. You can see the value here. Let's use equal to and not equal to operators in the condition. Change the variable b value from 4 to 6. And in the condition, I am using equal to operator. This condition returns true, or you can say evaluates to true, because 6 is equal to 6. And the result would be this string. Click Run. This is the output. If I change the operator from equal to not equal to, the result would be this string. The condition will return false. Because according to this condition, 6 is not equal to 6, which is obviously not true. You can see the result here. To confirm, let's print the value of a condition. Yes, it is false. I have written a complete step-by-step article on ternary operator. In the article, I have used images and code examples just to make sure you understand the topic thoroughly. You can find the article link in the description below. And one request, if you like the article, please share it.